You know, I was brought up in Cumbernauld and then Mogai, and we saw the occasional cow, but I never thought that I'd end up somewhere as rural and as remote as Orkney. Every parish is unique, but I think the things that are a real challenge here is the remoteness. There's a real focus on children in the community at large and in the church, and that means that there's a lot of investment in kids, and then for a lot of kids they're moving away to university, so you're losing a whole lot of the local population. It's a much more dispersed community, so it takes a lot longer to get from house to house. I've spent most of my first 6 months just getting lost and getting to know people by going to the wrong house. The weather's like a kind of cantankerous member of the congregation, so it dictates so much of life up here. Orkney's a hard place to be weak, you know, and there's difficulties with mental illness here, like there are in lots of places, but even where we are right now is a place where some people come because they feel that they can't go on, and that they would be better off throwing themselves off these cliffs, and it's horrendous. I've had my own experiences of mental illness, and I decided to talk about them because of that, because of the stigma attached to it. And so just to be open about your own experience sometimes can be a helpful way for others to say, aye, me too. I think a big part of what I'd like to see happen is for everyone to realise that they have a part to play. And that the church isn't something imposed on folk, that it's not about somebody standing 6 feet above contradiction and bossing everyone around, but actually it's about exploring what is it that God's doing here and what's your part in it and how can you help. I love a messy cup because it's not just that the kids are coming, but their parents are coming too and their grandparents. So it's whole families coming to explore about God and learn together.
He's a really good minister. I think he's what the Kirkus need him because he's got a young family and hopefully he'll be in the Kirk for a while.
He's always quite comical and keeps us on task, and he opens up to our ideas and what we want to do with the youth group as well.
Him and the kids, I think he's brilliant. I mean, my daughter speaks about him at other times too, so yeah, it's good. Very much different for things, for the way you would perceive things to be.
Well, we're trying to make as many connections as we can between the generations, and it's something the school have been very keen on as well, so all the kids going through primary school will be doing projects with the care home, and the care home themselves are really keen for that to happen, so what's tremendous is that everybody agrees that it's a good thing to do. So we came up with the pillowcases as an idea of, you know, there's a lot of creative kids in the Kirk, and if they can be putting that creativity to use in a way that blesses folk who are in the care home, that they realise that they matter and the kids are thinking about them, then it's a kind of practical way of showing that we're all in this together and trying to share the love of God amongst us all.
And if you would like a pillowcase, if you could tell us your name and maybe something that you like that we could draw in the middle of the pillowcase. So we're basically taking orders. But there's no money changing hands.
Would you like them to put something on the pillowcase to your picture?
They all react to young people. The smile, and you know, you can just tell that they're really happy.
I want to walk with God.
I just love music, and I always have, and so it's kind of natural that I, you know, want to use that and express that in different ways. It was important for me as a teenager. It was a way that actually kept me in the church, was being able to play and knowing that there was a place for music there. So I'm keen for other folk to have that kind of experience that I did. Some of these Bible stories are quite difficult or quite challenging, but to be able to express it in ways that kids can get and can sing and can remember is something that, well, you've seen at Messy Kirk, it's a great way of enabling folk to sing a wee bit of what it's about. I think one of the best things about ministry is the surprises. You know, you don't know what's happening today, let alone tomorrow, let alone next week. And so in training for ministry, whatever you think you might be capable of, or wherever you think you might be serving, God's probably having a laugh about it, because where you end up could be totally different. And so to have that openness to starting the adventure, even if you don't know where it's going to take you, because I never thought that I would end up here, and I'd never thought I'd find this so fulfilling, but it's a wonderful fit.